of your friends, yes.
You're not
running up. And I just told you,
we have only 1 minute.
That the fundamental lessons we should take from there. 33 pulling units they have in Kenya. No, 33,000 pulling units. They have a total of 14.3 million registered voters. All right? Now, the attitude of the people at the polling unit, no politicians, as they have said, well trained. So training, very important. So for us, the other said things that obviously I will not discuss here, which are very useful lessons for us internally that we are going to work on. But one interesting thing is that the Kenya, despite the fact that, because one of the reasons why I went to Kenya was because of ethnic issue in Kenya. They have about 70 ethnic groups in Kenya. The Kikuyu, they are the majority, where we have Jomo, this Kenyatta, where it's coming from, all right? Now, at play in this election, in terms of what we are saying now, there's also the issue about ethnicity over there. In fact, I wouldn't say that somehow we're a bit more mature somehow here, because if you look at what happened in 1993 elections and subsequent elections, in terms of the pattern of voting here, I would say that that's not where we are in terms of ethnic issue in Nigeria, we are still ahead. Two, very important, the election, there are some places where, for instance, a campaigner of an MP who has lost now was found at the polling unit with envelope containing money for inducement of voters. What happened? On Tuesday, he was arraigned. He was arrested by the police. It was not a case of the police now phoning the MP. One of your representatives here, and make an arrangement, nothing. He was arraigned the second day, and he had been jailed for 3 years. Similarly,
no question at all.
He had been jailed for 3 years. Secondly, Zabedi, in the one area, has also was found a presiding officer who issued more than two ballot papers. More than two ballot, was issuing two ballot papers to people.
Professor.
Now, he has been investigated, he's been arraigned. The matter has come up again on the 27th. Similarly, the movement for the Mombasa Republican Council that carried out Mondo's activity on Sunday that led to the death of people, all right, has also been arraigned for murder charges. Now, what is important, what I've seen there, is that election day is a day where the institution of a state, of a country, will be put to test, that of IEBC, that of INEC, that of the police, that of the judiciary. Unlike what we have here, and this is where I have a problem in this country, that on the election period, for instance, the NBC has a role to play under Section 100 of the Electoral Act, to the effect that all registration television stations owned by the state, they must be equal access and parity to all stakeholders. Does that happen in Nigeria?
Nope.
What do they do? Does it happen in this country? Similarly, you have seen the attitude of security people over there. We have seen that of a judge. In fact, Elizabeth Osoro, who is the magistrate judge who delivered that judgment on Tuesday, said that election rigging is a terrible offense in this country, that they are mindful of what happened in 2007, and that the maximum punishment must be given. But what happened in Cross River State, where people who violated the process at the two local government, they were arraigned, they collected bribes, they admitted, we were in court, they were charged. What happened? The magistrate sat and said, look, I know you are supposed to go to the election petition tribunal. Why are you coming this time around? In any case, where are your witnesses? Well, I don't have jurisdiction. And that was what happened in Cross River. So, the point is that
done to those people.
We already have appealed this matter. We will go
it's
to the Supreme
being
Court.
Appealed.
All right. I'm telling you the attitude of people.
So that's the
parallel. You were there in the
3 years.
In the UK, in 2010, you also saw what happened in the UK. When people destroyed in the eastern part of UK, judges were sitting overnight to get that dealt with. So in our country, the greatest lesson is the rule of law. That the rule of impunity cannot work. And the only way to move the democratic process outside the limit where it is now, to terms that are compatible with the highest expectation and ideal of Nigeria, is to ensure that the rule of law, you know, take precedence at all times.
All right, thank you very much, Mike. We have to wrap it up. The comparison is very, very obvious in terms of within 2 days, a case was arraigned, judge sat or magistrate sat, decision was taken, and that person has been sentenced to 3 years imprisonment. Nigeria, it could go on for 5 years, and impunity is
and in
a
the
major.
End, nothing happens.
Nothing
the person will work.
Yeah, exactly. The person will work. So that's a sad case. We will not be able to take final words anymore because time is not our friend on this program at this point.
What is that our friend? I don't know what
we have to find something
to do like this.
We can't
do our friend.
Yes.
We will deal with this enemy.
I think we can wrap it up like this. The basic problem we have in this country is that everybody feels he's above the law and nobody wants to respect the law. And once you don't respect the law, you don't get anything right.
On that note, we have to say thank you very much to you, starting with yourself, Sadiq Abubakar Musa, the INEC Resident Commissioner in Yobe State. We thank you very much. And also thanks to Mikey Gini, INEC Resident Commissioner in Cross River State. And of course, Yemi Adamalekun, who was an independent observer in Kenya and also the leader and chairperson of Enough is Enough.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. Well, sunrise is not going away. We'll be moving on to the penultimate session on this program in just a minute. So don't go away. Grab another cup of tea and then